Hello again, Sandro de Gregorio here. With this third video, we will see how to implement the zone of proximal development to the EcoThings project. In the previous video, we explained what it is. Let's see what we did to actually use it for the challenging scopes of the project. There were two schools involved in the project. The first one, the Spanish one, is my school, Colegio Santiago Apostol. And the second one is a Turkish school. Our school is a primary school and the Turkish school is secondary school. During the first and 2 years of the project, eco-technology courses were set up in Spain, left picture, and Turkey, right picture. The students were taught 3D and printing, 3D design and printing, block programming tools using Facilino software, and domotics. It's important to highlight the barriers they faced. On the left, the Spanish school, in the previous video already mentioned that we work exclusively with children at risk of social exclusion, with social, economic, and cultural barriers. The Turkish students have geographical barriers. Some of them come from very little towns far away from the school and they have to face huge difficulties to attend classes. So what we did during these two courses was implementing the interactive groups described in the first video in both courses. So the kids learned from each other using these groups made of 3 to 6 people with 1 or 2 adults supervising. And in Turkey, the more knowledgeable other was, at least at the beginning, the teacher. So standard procedure. In Spain, during the first year, it was the teacher as well. But during the second year, we decided to push somehow the learning process. And we involved university students from the Polytechnic University of Valencia. So the university students were the more knowledgeable others who taught the Spanish primary pupils how to deal with block programming and domotics. As you can see in the picture, let's retake the Venn diagrams from the previous video. You may see that on the left, we have the Spanish students and their zone of proximal development, which is the blue area. And on the right, you have the Turkish students, ZPD, in this case highlighted as a yellow area. And as I said before, on the right, the yellow area in Turkey was stretched by using teachers as more knowledgeable others. On the left, the ZPD was stretched by using teachers, local teachers during the first year, and university students during the second year, which was a wonderful occasion for both the university students who had the chance to be trainers for some days, but also for our kids to empathize and to communicate with younger people. Of course, the challenges were different in both countries. In Spain, we have a primary school. In Turkey, we have a secondary school. So in Spain, the goals were to connect the sensors to the CPU and control the sensors up to a certain point. That's the picture on the left. The picture on the right shows you a fully operative smart house with plenty of sensors and, of course, the motherboard, even powered by solar panels. And this is what the Turkish students managed to do during the eco-technology courses. What was left to implement from the pedagogical perspective, so zone of proximal development and theory of social learning, was having the Turkish students teach the Spanish students how to build a fully operative smart house. So as you can see, we are pushing further the border and we are lowering the age of the more knowledgeable others and pushing the zone of proximal development and the theory of social learning to its edge. During April 2024, specifically from April 15 to 19, a selection of Turkish students taught 6th primary Spanish students how to build the smart house. They were organized in three different interactive groups, the same interactive groups we described in the first pedagogical video. Two Turkish students were the more knowledgeable others in this group, and they helped 3 to 4 Spanish primary students to build a room of the house. The house was made of basically 3 rooms, a kitchen, living room, and bedroom. Each interactive group worked on their own room until they managed to assemble everything. The experience was successful, and in the end also the Spanish students had their fully operative smart house, which was a considerable achievement if we take into account the barriers that separately the Spanish students have and the Turkish students have, and then the added barrier during this learning, training, and teaching activity in Spain, which was language. Of course, the only possible way to communicate was English, but though Turkish students had a good level of English and could express themselves and understand English quite well, the Spanish primary students, because of their age and because of the socio-economic background, they have very low English knowledge. So we had to use prints, schemes, we had to use the projector to show things, translators eventually, but we managed to overcome those difficulties also thanks to the help of the adults who were supervising each group and the effort of the Spanish pupils and the Turkish students. So that was possibly the culmination of the project. This experience showed that the theory of social learning works, the zone of proximal development works, and interactive groups as an educational technique work. Through these three pedagogical videos, I try to show you how a very pushed STEM approach based on block programming and domotics, very innovative one, can be implemented from the pedagogical perspective. On this slide, I added the technical and pedagogical guidelines, which you will find on the first link, and which merge the technical perspective and the pedagogical one to give any interested teacher or school all the tools that he or she needs to make domotics a reality in their classrooms. The second link is the link to the project itself, in which you will find far more information, including this mock, but also a picture about the LTTA, how the eco-technology courses were structured, and even spin-off activities linked to the project. The theory of social learning is also highlighted here if you want to delve into it. And in case you think that learning communities are a valid option for your educational purposes, you can find the link here, which is the second from the bottom, in which you can see how this solution, which is widespread in Spain, can be a powerful ally, especially if you work with kids at risk of social exclusion. And finally, our school website, santiagoapostolcabanyal.es, where you can verify that EcoThings is just one of the many projects that our school is dealing with right now, and how we work strategically with a network of more than 80 collaborators. Thank you for following me through these pedagogical guidelines, and I really hope that this input can prove useful to all of you.